contrary, the outlook for an upsurge in carotid stenting or CAS is bright. I have no financial conflicts, although I, like everybody else, have lots of biases. Despite some opinions to the contrary, carotid stenting or CAS is currently in decline, generally, for the treatment of both symptomatic and asymptomatic carotid stenosis. And this is because with symptomatic carotid stenosis patients, recent randomized trials, you know them, CREST and ICSS, population-based studies, and a systematic registry review, which you probably don't know, show much higher stroke and death rates with CAS than CEA. And with most asymptomatic carotid stenosis patients, best medical treatment has such low stroke rates that it may make CAS and CEA unnecessary. And you can see here the annual stroke rate yearly for asymptomatic carotid stenosis patients has fallen from 3 to 6% per year, now down to less than 1% per year. And that's because of best medical treatment and status. The important new evidence, which is something that possibly you don't know, is one article by Spence, which confirms the low risk of occlusion, less than 1%. And when occlusion occurs, the low risk of stroke, surprisingly, 0.9% in patients that have asymptomatic carotid stenosis on good medical treatment. This is shocking new data suggesting the benignity of this lesion. And a second recent article by Ross Naylor and Paris Kivas was a systematic review of stroke and death rates after CAS and CEA in 21 contemporary administrative registries. And this review showed that CAS had significantly higher stroke and death rates than CEA in most of these registries, both with symptomatic and asymptomatic carotid stenosis patients. And here are some of the details. The CAS stroke and death rate for the average, in this registry review, for average risk symptomatic carotid stenosis exceeded, surprisingly, the AH guideline of 6% in 72% of 18 registries, and in 28%, it actually exceeded 10%. That's shocking and much worse than all the randomized trials. So carotid stenting or CAS is currently in decline generally for the treatment of both symptomatic and asymptomatic stenosis. However, it's my belief that CAS has a bright outlook because of three advances which may decrease the strokes that occur from it. One is better embolic protection devices, the cessation of reversal flow, the moment of ice. The other is cervical access to the Silk Road system to avoid the aortic arch and reverse flow. And the third you just heard about from Dr. Muselik is membrane or mesh covered stents to stop delayed strokes. Now this was our ex vivo carotid stenting model, which was described and talked about in 1995. This is one of my carotid endarterectomy specimens wrapped in a vortex wrap to simulate the adventitia tissue, placed in an introducer, and then in a water bath, perfused with saline while through this introducer, we carried out under x-ray control a carotid stent as the lesion was being perfused. It's a very cheap experiment, didn't cost us anything. And here's the high-grade stenosis, that's the lumen, wasn't a total occlusion. And here you can see luminal restoration restored by the stent, beautifully. But it produced all these particles. And this very cheap experimental work led to all the embolic protection devices which you heard and read about. And so these membrane mesh covered stents are a way to stop delayed strokes. Now, interestingly, about two-thirds of strokes in some studies occur after the protection device is out, either in post-op, post-procedural period, or after the patient's discharged from the hospital. So this is a big deal. And here you see why these occur. In our model, these debris protruding through the stent, and as flow is restored, protection device out, these are washed off and care, causing late strokes. And the solution is these membrane or mesh covered stents. You heard about the CGuard device. There's also a Gore mesh covered carotid stent and the Terumo road saver stent. All accomplish the same things with various different pore sizes and other qualities. And here's a higher view of this micro mesh road saver stent. Now the trials with these covered stents are promising, mesh covered stents, but we need more work and we need late results to be sure these new type stents don't cause a late increase in stenosis. We don't know that yet. The other two advances that may decrease strokes with CAS are better involved protection devices with cessation of reversal flow or normal device. Unfortunately, the Gore device has been discontinued. And most importantly, cervical access with the Silk Road system to avoid the open arch cause of stroke and to reverse flow. The cardiologists don't like it, you'll see why in a second, but I think they should. And this system is shown here. It requires a little cut down in the neck. And the carotid, common carotid is dissected free and controlled. The cardiologists don't like it because it requires a cut down in the neck. Doesn't matter, but it's probably better. And into this carotid artery is placed a small sheath, short sheath, and through the sidearm of this sheath, flow is reversed. It can be controlled variably. It goes through a filter, and then it goes back. With this reversal flow, the blood is put back into the opposite femoral vein, and then through the other arm of the sheath, the carotid stenting procedure is carried out. Now, the outcomes with this system in three trials, some of which included very high-risk patients, have been very good. So the early results in these trials are promising and have resulted in low stroke and DWMRI lesions. But again, we need more trials and longer-term results. So for symptomatic and asymptomatic patients, if these three advances decrease CAS stroke rates, CAS would be a more competitive to CEA and would replace CEA more widely than it currently does. For asymptomatic patients, there are promising ways on the horizon to select those few, not many, at high risk of stroke. And you know about these, CCD-detected microemboli, duplex plaque evaluation, including 3D duplex, MRI and CT plaque evaluation, etc. And with these systems, some groups have reported asymptomatic carotid stenosis patient groups that have a over 12% greater chance of having a stroke as opposed to less than 1% in the general population. So these high-risk asymptomatic patients selected by these methods clearly would benefit from CAS or CEA in addition to the best medical treatment that they all want to be on, thus increasing the number of patients needing CAS and reducing the number of unnecessary CAS procedures in asymptomatic patients. What that percentage is, I don't know, but it's low, probably around 3 to 6%. However, there's one reservation, and that is that the efficacy of these three methods for decreasing CAS stroke rates and improving asymptomatic patient selection must be proven by appropriate clinical trials. Despite this reservation, I believe the outlook for carotid stenting and CAS is bright in the future, and all vascular specialists and vascular surgeons should prepare for this by learning how to do this procedure. Thanks for your attention. Thanks for having me.